The Kenyan National Assembly's Committee on National Cohesion is leading discussions in Nairobi aimed at finding lasting solutions to the crisis of hate speech and ethnic polarization in Kenya. KTN's Patrick Amimo is following the events at Nairobi's Kasarani area and now joins us by way of phone. Patrick, the Director of Public Prosecution said yesterday there was need for tougher actions on politicians who spew hate speech and incite their constituents to violence. What are the members of Parliament saying today?
Thank you so much, Michelle. Indeed, today the workshop is ongoing, and we saw at least the Communication Authority of Kenya was invited here to share some of its views on the challenges it's been facing and all the measures it's been putting in place to ensure that those who perpetuate hate speech on social platforms are dealt with. And from the presentation, we saw the chairperson of the Board of Directors of the Communication Authority of Kenya, Ben Ituku, indicate that they've already established a Kenya Computer Incident Response Coordination Team that is monitoring what happens at cyber cafes, and especially in relation to cyber crime. This team is told the members of Parliament that it's been very, very successful in ensure in monitoring those who are committing various crimes through social media and the cyber in the cyber cafes. And this team has been able to monitor those individuals and stand action, immediate action taken against them. It's also indicated that those are registered companies that provide mobile companies, say like Safaricom and Airtel, is expressed concern that some of these companies, their SIM cards are being used, and yet they are not registered, and these SIM cards are being used to commit crime. So he's issued a veiled warning saying that these particular companies, if they don't up their game, then stern action might be taken against them for allowing the use of unregistered SIM cards. Remember, 3 years ago, all companies were asked to have people using their SIM cards registered, but it appears there's still a loophole which is being exploited by criminals or some individuals with criminal intent to obtain SIM cards without registration and also use them to commit a felony. And especially now as you approach the election running period, these such a registered card, SIM cards might be used by people to perpetuate hate and incitement across the country. That's why the authority is issuing these early warning to these particular mobile companies to ensure that all individuals using their telephone lines are registered in order to have a database so that in case that line is used for hate speech or any other form of crime, action is taken against that particular individual. What other thing that the chairperson has indicated is that there is also the commission, the Communication Authority of Kenya has also introduced a programming code for broadcaster media in Kenya, that's television and radio, where now this particular programming will ensure that we'll be able to issue guidelines for politicians who appear in talk shows or other television talk shows and radio programs, where now politicians will be not allowed to make inciting statements when they are on air. And he says that these particular regulations will also come up with punitive measures and fines to ensure that politicians don't incite their audiences, especially when they are selling their political agenda in the run up to the election. So these are some of the measures that the Communication Authority has put in place to ensure that the coming elections are run smoothly and communities are not divided along party or ethnic lines. Michelle.
As that is Patrick Amimo reporting from Kasarani. The authorities are putting in place measures to end hate speech and ethnic polarization in the run-up to the 2017 general elections.